I'm on my way to see the new GP. I lost sight of...
What happened?
I might be having a TIA. It's happened before. I'm sorry I didn't tell you.
You've been keeping this secret from me?
I'm sorry.
No! How could you do this to us?
I just heard. What happened? Are you okay?
Look, I'm fine, Bubs. Take it easy, eh?
If you're so fine, why are you in an emergency department? What's wrong?
He thought he'd had a mini stroke. Another one.
It was just a migraine.
What about this mini stroke? When was that?
A couple of weeks ago.
Dad?
But I didn't want you all getting in a state like you are now.
You're our dad. We love you. Of course we're in a state. Where's Mum?
I don't know.
Oh, I'm really glad you were here.
Yeah, only just. Wendy was here, but she left.
Why?
She wasn't very happy with me.
Well, that can't be right.
He didn't tell Wendy either.
Oh, Dad.
Okay, Bowles. Can I go now? Look, I really need to talk with Wendy.
Well, no, the only thing you should be doing is resting.
A very quick word with Wendy and then I'll rest, okay?
Okay, I'll do the paperwork.
Okay, so what's the story? Does he get some treatment or something?
No, well, your dad knows what's what. He's not in any immediate danger. Look, I'm happy to explain to you everything that he needs to do, but I'm just a bit pushed for time.
No, it's okay. Dad can tell me.
Well, if you do have any questions.
Thanks. I'm sorry you haven't been well, Dad. I'm also sorry for Mum, so I'm going to go find her.
Okay.
You know why we're cross, don't you?
I hadn't thought about taking out the walls.
It'll make it a hell of a lot easier for Mum.
It's not a bad idea.
Hi, Mr. Adams. How's Elaine?
She's not so bad, thanks.
We still don't know if she's going to get any mobility back.
Getting home will perk her up. Well, toilet stop for me, and then we'll head off, eh? See you up front.
Looks like you two are getting on okay.
Yeah, we're good. Great, in fact.
He's got what he wanted. You're moving back to the farm.
You're never going to think it's a good idea, are you?
Well, I was there when you told your mum you wanted more.
Yeah, well, getting on with Dad means a lot. And being there for Mum.
Yeah, I know. Don't mind me, it's just I'll miss you.
Yeah, same. Hey, you haven't got rid of me yet. I still got to break Mum out of the spinal unit. That will take a few days. Hey, drinks tonight with some of the Ambos. You should come.
Oh, no, I'll leave it to you boys. But just promise me you'll say a proper goodbye.
Yeah, of course. I'll text you.
Hey. Hey. He's happy?
He was out of besties. A major miracle. And I still had to be down about the whole moving to the farm thing.
That's because you don't want him to go. Because
no.
But he said that he loved you.
He was drugged up.
Yeah, but maybe the sedation brought out his deeper feelings.
Stop trying to make a thing out of this. Okay, all Dallas can think about is paddocks and cows and fences and his mum and dad. Okay, and I don't fit anywhere in that. And he's happy. You know, maybe I was wrong. He's finally found what he's looking for.
Hello? Caleb, finally they let you talk to me. Are you really okay? So I don't have an invalid for a husband? I see. Well, I look forward to seeing you then. When? Okay. I love you. Bye.
He's okay?
Yeah. He doesn't know exactly when he'll be home, but soon. A few days.
Good one.
I don't think I can concentrate on TV. I've got some paperwork to do. Should try to stay up to date so I've got time for Caleb.
Yeah, good idea.
Who has been at this desk moving things around? I left it right here.
Hey, tell me what it is and I'll find it.
It's got to be here somewhere.
Wendy, let me, please, then you can head back to Murray.
Well, why would I do that? He doesn't need me. He just carry on doing as he pleases. And why are you two just standing here? Do you need something to do?
No, we're fine. Come on. Mum, I know what's happened, and of course you're angry. I am too, but... Oh, you're sad now.
Wins.
Not so... now. I've got too much to do, and you shouldn't be dragging yourself up here.
Well, I'm here because I want to
say... Did you not hear me? I'm busy.
You should get home, Dad. Now's not the time.
Yeah, let's go.
He is really sorry, Mum. He was so wrong, but he was trying to protect us. You need to let him apologize and just let it go.
Just like that? I don't think so.
But what if something happens to Dad and you're still angry with him? He needs you.
That's just it. He decided he didn't.
He was wrong, wasn't he? And you don't want to be wrong too, and everything gets worse, which it will, you know that. Please, Mum.
Oh, you don't look too shabby.
No, I didn't go too mad with the boys. Still a good night, though. Hey, big news.
Your mum gets out today?
Could be, but no. London are headhunting Kiwi Ambos. Job's guaranteed and the pay's damn good.
Sounds okay.
Yeah, they pay for your flights, arrange visas, help you with accommodation.
What, so just like that, you're throwing away your gumboots and your carpoo, huh?
No, I'm thinking about you.
Me?
Yeah, you get to see some of the world. I mean, you'd love it, wouldn't you?
As if I'm anywhere near experienced enough.
No, you're exactly what they're looking for. Young, sharp, keen as. You gotta do it. I mean, what's keeping you back here?
Mum?
What, because you're always over in Akatea?
Hey, I just got back from there. And I don't go lots, but Mum's there when I need her. And I've got other mates too. You were one of them before you lost your mind and decided you were a farm boy.
Hey, there'll always be me, farm boy or whatever. But what would be wrong with a whole lot of new mates, new country, new life, new experiences?
Okay, I might just think about it.
Oh, he's a bit of all right. Those bedroom eyes. I thought all you'd have to do is whistle.
Huh?
And the boys would come running.
I'll try to triage next time, shall I?
Yeah, could be fun. At least this way you get to do some screening, I guess.
I'm still a bit risky.
Wait, I think I'm in love.
What, him?
No, back one. Yes, him. Mm. Nice chest. Oh, the chin and the hair. Very dubious.
What are you guys up to?
We're doing a bit of objectifying.
What?
Kylie's trying to get her hands on some prime beef. It's been too long, evidently.
Yeah, stop!
Oh, it's okay. We'll probably come across his nibs any minute. Wouldn't you get snaffled up just like that?
We're on a dating site.
Oh, right.
It's shocking, I know.
No, it's the way to go these days. You just have to play it safe.
Yeah, meet in the public spot, I know, yeah.
No, Leanne, it's a bit too soon for me.
Oh, yes, I'm so sorry. Oh!
What?
Looks like I might be going for a drink tonight.
Why? Show me. Jeff. Very nice.
Yeah, I think so. We've been texting for a while now, and he's made me laugh, so why not?
You go, girl.
Hey, Mum. Mum?
It's okay.
What's happened?
She fell out of a chair.
What?
No, she's fine. It just gave us a bit of a fright, that's all.
What if it happens when we're back home and you two are off working somewhere?
We just have to make sure that it doesn't happen again, okay?
Dad, if she's not going to feel safe there, then maybe we should...
Don't you go a gloom merchant on me. Look, we're going all out to make the place easy for her. I mean, it was your idea about the walls and there's other stuff. There's ramps and there's hoists and so on.
A hoist? Well, does that make me sound like some huge thing?
Dad, I think we need to think about this.
No, we just have to get cracking on modifying things.
Which won't be cheap.
Oh, don't you start. Look, there's subsidies. And the doctors will have a handle on it. I'll be back in a tick.
Not listening, is he? The thought of going back to the farm... it's not just because I'll be on my own sometimes. God, these alterations are still going to take a lot of time and money, and we don't have much of either. I'm no use to anyone like this. I mean...
Come on. I want to be there too, remember?
We'll all get so sick of going to the hospital and back. It's not like it's just down the road. Like I said, once your father's made up his mind.
Here you are.
Yep, it's me all right.
Woke up in the middle of the night and you weren't there.
Slept in the spare room. Didn't want to disturb you.
Well, you didn't want to be anywhere near me.
I still can't understand.
Well, I was trying not to drag you down, not when you were being D.O.N.
Rubbish! I haven't been D.O.N. for 2 weeks. So come on, why? Tell me.
I don't know. But I tell you, and it's real, isn't it? Well, that we're not going to go on forever. For some of us, that may be way sooner than we think.
Well, ignoring it won't make it go away.
Well, I haven't been ignoring it. I've been trying to keep myself well. Been running, watching what I eat.
And you still got a terrible migraine, so what next?
Look at you all upset. I've been trying to spare you that.
We are in this together, buddy. Me and the kids, we can help keep you well.
I'm not a cop case. I don't need looking after, not by a long shot. I'm getting dressed and I'm going to work.
No, you're not.
I am not feeble and I'm not soft in the head. I'm organising some time off. I am looking after myself, okay?
Well, subsidies wouldn't cover it if you weren't doing the work yourself, but we will be, won't we?
You have to remember you're back.
Well, this one's fit enough. And with my know-how, we'll get the place in shape in no time.
Yeah, we're going to need consents for some of the work, and the alterations could affect the value of the place when we do come to sell it.
Not if you do a good job. And you will if you listen to me. Stop your nitpicking, eh?
I'm just not sure this is the best solution for Mum.
When we're going all out to make the place just right for her.
But it could take some time, couldn't it?
Well, we'll have to push ourselves. You're not scared of a bit of hard work, are you? We'll get there. We'll be just fine.
Lucky guy, I say.
We'll see about that. Hello.
Sorry, I think I might have time to get you a drink.
That's not too much bother.
It's just I've been organising some time off.
Oh, good man.
You're looking very nice.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, she's meeting the guy.
Oh, okay. You early or is he late?
Yeah, I thought he might be here already.
Oh, meanwhile, a little Bina.
Marie, the guy's collapsed.
Man, I'm going to miss you so much, cuz.
I'm not going here, and I probably won't.
Well, you said that they said you're just what they're looking for.
Yeah, well, I thought it was just Dallas mouthing off, but yeah.
Man, you're young, you're single in London. You're going to love it, and they're going to love you.
No, it just doesn't feel right.
Why?
Well, I'm practically a baby Amber, really.
Ah, what, are you a scaredy cat?
No.
No, you're not. So why? Ah, you and Garrett haven't fanned the flickering embers.
No way.
What, is there someone else?
No.
Hey, you hesitated.
I did not.
Yes, you did. What, have you got your little eye on someone?
No.
What? If love's not holding you back, then you just grab it with two hands and shake it around. Well, that's up to you, of course. Still gonna miss you. Yeah, come here.
Oh, stop it.
He's got a good pulse.
Do we know how many drinks he's had?
Well, not enough to do this to him, I hope.
Just a soda.
I've seen this guy before. Can you grab his wallet? A name might help. Oh, Jeff, hi. Sorry, I'm a bit busy right now.
Yeah, okay.
Anderson, Kevin James?
Yes, that's right. He came in for a cholecystectomy a couple of weeks ago. A juice, please. He's got diabetes.
Yeah, he's having a hypoglycemic episode. That's you good.
Ready?
Just about. Here you go.
Here we go, Mr. Anderson. It's going to make you feel better. Yep, that's good. A few more.
The farm is wrong for Mum. I mean, she knows that. I do too now, but Dad just won't see it. I know. And I tried to tell him, but I could see Mum was getting upset. She didn't want us rowing.
So your dad's gonna get what he wants and your poor mum has to suffer.
Well, she'd rather that than upset him.
And then there's you. You don't want to upset him either because finally you're getting on.
You were right. Mum doesn't want to go back to the farm. I was only going back to please Dad, and he's only going back because it's what he knows. Walking away will feel like he's failed, so why didn't I listen to you?
You just said it. There was a whole lot of other stuff going on. And yeah, it's been hard for you and your dad to get where you are. And you might lose him, but he needs telling. And he's probably going to be relieved to be told.
Yeah, right. Look, thanks for listening to me bleat on. You're a real mate.
No worries. Anything else I can help you with today?
Some OJ and the guy came around pretty quick. Lucky Kylie and Tico were there, otherwise he could have been a goner.
That must have made you think about your scare.
Well, not really. There's no point in dwelling on it. I'm focused on staying well now.
Good on you, Dad. And what about your mum?
Oh, we're all right.
Oh, so you had a good talk. Mum was so upset.
Well, I'm not hiding anything anymore. But onwards and upwards.
With a bit of healthy living, like you should join my Boomba class.
Oh, yeah, bust out the Lacra Shorts, Maz.
I don't think so.
Well, I can definitely help you with your diet. I've got like a zillion recipes for healthy salads. Mm.
The big thing is to reduce your stress and work less. Like, I can come back, you can chuck as many shifts at me as you like, truly.
Settle down, you two. I've got it all in hand, thanks very much.
But we want to help Dad, because we're health conscious already, so we've got lots of tips on living a long and healthy life.
Do you really live longer, or does it just feel like it?
It's no joking matter if that was meant to be a joke.
Well, I'm just asking if I can be in charge of my own Stay Well program. I mean, I don't want you too worrying. There is no need. I mean this in the nicest possible way, but help, please.
Got a fan for life there.
It's pretty basic stuff.
Oh, we're so onto it, though. And remembering the guy's name. I mean, did we even find out why he was drinking alone?
Waiting for a friend.
We like you, really. Where is that guy? I thought he was hanging around.
Did you send Jeff off to the cafe?
Sorry.
What, he bolted?
He made all the right noises, said he had to be somewhere else and so on. But talking to him, I don't think you're missing much. Nicely put together, but, you know, not a lot going on between the ears.
Hey, you should have been made for each other.
I'll stop that. He was well impressed with you doing your whizzy nursey thing, but I'm sure he worked out that you're far too smart for him. Some men can't handle bright women, can they, TK?
Some men, no.
Not you, of course.
So, you never got to have that vino. Let me buy you one. Sure, it's just another life you saved, but it's always worth celebrating.
Sure. A joke would be nice.
Good.
Hey, you took your time. To start with...
Shh.
What? She doesn't want to be sleeping all the time.
I just don't want to sit here.
Oh, actually, well, I'll leave you in peace and we'll go and sort out
this.
Actually, you might have some ideas. We've got to do the painting as well, so you might
want to... Dad, you stop, please.
Eh?
I got something I want to say.
No, we've done talking. It's time for us...
No, we haven't. You've decided what we should do and you haven't been interested in what we think.
No.
Can you hear me out, please? Look, it's huge what's happened here and you're rushing me and Mum into something that is wrong for all of us.
Oh, this is nice. Here I am.
But Dad, I haven't finished yet.
Colin, please.
Going back to the farm is wrong for all of us. She needs to be much closer to the sort of care and support that she needs, and you're not fit enough to do all the alterations to the house and run the place, even with my help. It's too big an ask all around.
So we just pull the plug. After all the work I've put in, and your mother, all that time for nothing. Just a waste of time.
No, Dad, it isn't. It's been a good life for you and Mum, and for me when I was growing up, and for Todd. But things have changed. Think about ferrying Mum all that way to the hospital a couple of times a week, getting her to physio. Think about when we're way out on the farm and she gets stuck or has another fall. She's home alone and scared, maybe, in pain. You don't want that. I know you don't.
Maybe if we hold off going back for a little. It's okay. Thank you.
So how do you cope with the surgeons and their egos?
Teeny tiny egos in the emergency department.
We're a friendly bunch though, you know? We're good. And I think you'd fit right in. That's what I reckon. After today, I think you're a natural. You've got all the right stuff, the skills, making decisions on the spot. You should join us.
I am flattered. And I'd probably enjoy it, but I do love theatre work.
So. Oh, come on. Theatre work? That's boring. We've got the people, teamwork, the shiny tiles. Come to ED. Oh, sorry for my little girl. Oh, I could make a call and we could go eat.
That would be nice. Should we?
Why not?
Well, I already like you a lot. I could very easily like you a whole lot more. And you did say it was too soon.
I did. Damn. That Jeff, some kind of loser. He's messing up big time.
Oh, I know. I don't know about that. I have a knack for messing things up. Making the wrong choice is probably a lucky escape for both of us.
You can't give up now. It's way too soon.
I haven't. You do get over waiting for just the right one.
You sure you're not the least bit hungry?
Yeah, I am, but I won't.
Okay.
Thank you for asking, Mom. And thanks for the drink.
Hey, He didn't exactly get snippy with us.
But he did use the words butt out.
Yeah, without telling us anything about his Stay Well program.
What do you know about it?
Well, not a lot. He was trying to get fit.
Well, that wasn't enough, was it? He's going to have to do more.
He'll end up with a dead dad or be paralysed down one side.
Look, he's just being a bit of a bloke about it. But he did get a fright, so of course he's looking after himself. He's asked Jackie to do some extra shifts so he can have some more time off.
Well, excuse Big Ears here, but go Murray.
Shouldn't that be go slow, Murray?
Yes, but also diet and exercise. But Murray knows what's up, so I'm sure he'll be doing everything he should.
Thanks, Harper, so we can lay off the nagging.
Yeah, we don't want him to think we don't care about him, so we can take turns. Maybe we should make a roster.
I can hardly talk to him about it, let alone nag. I wouldn't have known about any of this if he'd had his way.
But he's going to work less.
Oh, that'd be a token effort, I'd say. We should be facing this together, but that would mean him admitting that he's not the big strong man he wants us to think he is. It's just dumb male pride.
Not so you don't think he's going to look after himself?
No, he'll try. I mean, he has been trying. But if we can't talk about it and do the healthy stuff together, like exercising and being careful with what we eat, it's just too easy to let things slip, isn't it?
Yeah, but he'll still be trying to get his head around it. You know, you can but try to get him to let you in.
Well, that'd be nice. If it brought us closer and not further apart, because that's how it's feeling right now, and I could lose him.
No. You can't think like that. I'm sure he's not so proud that he'll ignore this little warning.
No. But whatever happens, I will be there for him, and we will get through. We always do.
You want a beer?
No. I'm putting the farm on the market. We'll get your mother right, then we'll see where we're at. She's talked about travelling. That's a ways off, but never say never, eh?
That's good, Dad. Really good. What about us?
Catch you later.
It looks pretty serious.
Yeah. Selling the farm.
I owe you big time, and we all do.
I'm not going to be a farm boy anymore. Thanks, mate. Thank you so much.
Well, I just gave you a wee push like you gave me.
Hey.
I'm going to the UK.
You got the job?
Well, they're pretty positive. But I'm going to go anyway, for a year at least. So, Bubbles, are you in? You are. So there.